So, we know the term mechatronics is maybe not always a, a clear-cut term that everybody is as familiar with or knows much about. So, Craig, maybe just to start our conversation, could you maybe define what mechatronics is, or maybe what it means to a company like Schaeffler?
Sure, yeah. So I think, and to make it simple, mechatronics is a combination of mechanics, electronics, and software, usually embedded software. So for Schaeffler Group, that means developing products that consist of those different disciplines or components.
Okay. And so what would be some of the technologies associated with maybe a mechatronic system?
Sure, yeah. So I think the easy way to do it is to kind of break it down into those different elements that I just mentioned. So if we think of mechanics, then usually the component technology would be things like some type of transmission system. It could be planetary gears or strain wave gears, parallel gears, et cetera. Could be a screw-driven system like lead screws, roller screws, ball screws. Could be belt drives, rack and pinion, cam drives, et cetera. So usually there's something that's creating motion of some type. And so you have a mechanical transmission system. Then you'd have bearings that support the rotation of the system. You would have a structural housing, end plates, shafts, those type of things. And then in addition to that, you've got electronics like microcontrollers that do the intelligence or the control of the device. If it's a motor-related app product, then you would have typically a power driver in there as well. You usually have some type of sensing, so feedback sensing like position and speed, or torque and force, or vibration, those type of things. And then also, there's usually software included that's doing the control or adding the intelligence to those devices.
So, how is mechatronics being used within various types of applications? And are there maybe certain applications where you're seeing it used more, or or that most benefit from utilizing mechatronics?
Yeah, so I'd probably generalize and say, I guess when I think of mechatronics, it's usually to do some type of sensing on a machine or a vehicle, or to create motion. And so within those two spaces, there's usually an intent to use that to improve throughput or the efficiency of the machine. Like I have this machine and I want to add mechatronics in order to get more throughput or a lower production cost out of my machine. Or the other area would be to add comfort or user features. So if you say I want to buy a vehicle and I want to push a button and I want something to happen, I could pull a lever, mechanically, but I'd really like to push the button because it's more convenient for me. So I think those are typically areas that drive the use. And then application areas are everywhere. I mean, it's almost hard not to find mechatronics products once you've kind of defined it, like I'd mentioned earlier, because there's so many things today that integrate, electronics and software into a machine or device. And a couple of examples would be the off-road market, where you have tractors or scissor lifts, those type of things. So you'll see, traditional mechanical components like hydraulics, for example, but you also see a lot of trends to convert that into electromechanical or add intelligence to the hydraulics themselves. So electrification is a big push within that market to add this intelligence and efficiency to machines. Robotics is an area that's almost you can't have robotics without mechatronics because it's a very precise motion control application. And so typically you're having to have some type of embedded control and electronics in order to be able to accomplish that. So you see lots of examples in robot arms or the humanoid push that you see in the market today. All of those types of things have lots and lots of mechanical and I'm sorry, mechatronic examples inside of them.
What is the role that you maybe see hydraulics and pneumatics playing within the mechatronics space, either as part of that system or, with, in conjunction with it?
Sure. Yeah, I think when somebody says mechatronics, my first thought is usually towards electromechanical devices. So usually it's like, all right, I have hydraulics or pneumatics and I'm going mechatronic or electromechanical. And that's certainly, I guess, an example of mechatronics, but also I think you can say hydraulics and pneumatics can also have mechatronics embedded inside of it. So there's, servo control valves, for example, in hydraulics where you're trying to improve the efficiency of the system. And there you have electronics, doing some type of solenoid control and getting feedback in order to control the hydraulic loop. Similar on the pneumatic side, there's valve control to get better performance out of those systems. So I don't think that they're mutually exclusive. I think you can have mechatronics within those spaces. But of course, there's also the trend to evaluate those as technologies where you may be improving upon that by going, electromechanical mechatronic type systems.
Well, just kind of the last question I had for you is, how maybe have you seen the use of mechatronics evolve in recent years, and how do you foresee it continuing to evolve in the coming years?
I think there's definitely been an evolution or an advancement, I think, of the technology, more so on the electronics and the software side than the mechanics. So a lot of the mechanical technology has been existing for many years, certainly improvements on that. But where you really see a rapid improvement is more electronics and software. And if you look at electronic components that would go into circuit boards, like microcontrollers and integrated circuits, those have become much more available, much less expensive, smaller, more powerful, easier to use. So it really is an enabler then that you can create a lot more products at a lower barrier to entry than you could create previously. And then that opens up a lot more business cases and opportunities to put products into the market. And so I think that curve is continuing to accelerate, and the expectation is that it would, accelerate into the future. And then you have, market trends drive that as well. You have, robotics, AI, automation, electrification, all of these things that we hear a lot about in the news today. Those are all areas that need products that require mechatronics. So I think there's then the pull from the market side as well. And then maybe the last point would be also from the customer or the consumer side. People are much more familiar with electronics today than they were, decades ago, right? So you almost have an expectation among the modern consumer that they want these conveniences that they see in their car, that they have on their iPhone. They want that in their, machines and vehicles that they use, for other purposes as well. So I think that also then creates this pull to have that technology, in the market.
So are there potentially markets where mechatronics is, or applications where mechatronics is maybe not as widely used at the moment, but there could benefit from utilizing mechatronic systems?
I don't know that there's an untapped market. I would
Okay.
say, back to my comment earlier, it's really hard to think of a market that doesn't, use it in some form. I mean, if you go back in time, everything was mechanical. And then you can look at industries like textile, for example, right? It was all driven on gears and cams and timing of machines. And that's all those type of products were more difficult to make, right? You had less flexibility. And so I think the technology has already been, pretty broadly adapted. I mean, the areas where people would typically stick to more of a mechanical system, there may be a reason for that based on, power density or something else where it forces you into that space. But in general, I guess I don't see a market where it's, hasn't been discovered yet, I guess.
Okay. Just curious, sometimes there are those applications that are not quite utilizing the technologies. So, okay, great. Well, thank you so much for taking the time to speak with me today and provide some, your insight into, what mechatronics is and the technologies involved. And I think it'll really help our readers to understand the technology more.